I'm going to show you guys really quickly how to convert a raster image into a vector. And I'm going to show you three different methods, which will vary depending on which kind of file you have. So the first is going to be for this here little watercolor birdie. Second one is going to be for this logo, which is a basic single color logo design. And the third is going to be for a detailed line drawing. So they're all going to be slightly different. And I'm going to show you just for the sake of getting you familiar with the settings on what's called image trace, which is how we're going to convert these to vectors. First one is a watercolor. And if we zoom in really close, we're going to see, wow, this is a raster file. It's pixelated when you get really close, and that's the whole point of vectorizing something, is so that you can make it as large as you want to without losing any quality, without getting any pixelation, so that you can put this guy on like a billboard or the side of a building, or you can make it as big as you want it. Won't lose any quality. That's the beauty of vectors. All right, so here we go. So for this guy, first thing you're going to want to do is come up to Window if you don't already have Image Trace open, and make sure that Image Trace is checked. Open that guy up, bring him over wherever you want him, makes you comfortable. And come over to Preset. I'm not going to get into all the little buttons and all the little things. I'm just going to show you what I have found to work. So come to, for this case, we're going to use a high fidelity photo preset, which is basically like a really detailed preset. Because I want to keep all the detail in this guy. It's going to tell me, whoa, this is going to be really slow. Sure about this? Man, it's going to take forever. Just yes, I'm sure. If you have a really slow computer, like an old laptop from like the 80s or something, you might not want to do this, but I'm pretty sure you'll all be good. So what that did there is immediately, just in one click, vectorize that guy, if you can believe it. I mean, now there's no pixelation at all. This is entirely vector, all mathematical. We can scale him as big as we want him and he'll never lose quality. So really all we have to do now is fine tune. And that's where these settings come in. Now you might have this advanced thing closed. Just come over here to a little arrow and click it down to open it. The first thing I did with this guy is I brought up the colors. It was set to 85. I brought it to 100 because I wanted to just give him all the colors, because that gives him more nuance, more detail. Yeah, so I liked that. And then I just played around a bit with these. The paths didn't really do it for me. They didn't really help, neither did the corners. But I noticed that when I brought the noise up really high, I liked how it looked. But if I zoom out, I mean, like, man, that looks real good. And it's a vector. That's real crazy. So now, as you can see, there's like this white background that just formed on here, and we don't want that. So you got to go from, if the method is like on this overlapping, click over here to abutting, and then you'll have the option to ignore white, and it's going to take that white background away for you. Cool. Look at that. That's my bird. He's a vector now. So amazing. And when you get really close, it's like, oh, okay. But man, when you like zoom out, whoa. Now, I'm going to come over here, and this is for anyone who has like a logo design that's really simple, one or two colors. What I'm about to show you should do the trick for your logo, turning it from a raster to a vector. So come up here to preset, go on down to three colors. They didn't have an option for one or two colors, so that's just like the simplest one that they've got. And that looks pretty darn good, doesn't it? Let's see over here. Let's go to source image. Something's not right. Source image looks exactly like the tracing result. Nah, that's not a vector. Let's try that again. There we go. I don't know what happened. All right, so you're going to see once I click on three colors, it really simplifies it. And I'm not crazy about that. So what I did is I went in, adjusted some of these. And again, you can play around with what works for you. But what I did for this logo was on the palette, I changed it from limited to full tone. So that would bring back in some of the little nuances in the tree. See that? But then it made my circle kind of like too choppy. So I was like, I wonder how I could fix that. And what I found was that when I played with the colors, I brought them down to like 60, I think it was, and it really smoothed it out. Watch this. Yeah, look at that. And then I played around with the paths and corners, and that didn't really do anything that I liked. So I came down to noise and I brought it down to 1. And I think that was all I did to get it to where I liked it. I'm not even sure what exactly that just did, but there must have been a reason I did it. So, okay, so again, what the heck is going on? What the heck? Oh man, you guys. I was adjusting my bird. whatever, I'll fix that in a minute. All right, so get that out of there. Ignore that white. And then again, click on this guy, ignore the white. So that's it for the logo. And now if you happen to have a highly detailed line drawing like this, just select it. And what I have found, sort of counterintuitive, you would think it'd be like line art or technical drawing or something, but those didn't really do it for me. What I found was just like the bird, I used high fidelity photo. And that at first is gonna look real crazy, but then I adjusted some stuff. Look at that, And then it ended up like looking real good. You'll see. What I did was I changed the color mode. All right, so I'm gonna show you. If you keep it, you would think like, oh yeah, it should be in black and white. That's crazy. That's like, where's all my detail? So I was like, nah, I'm gonna keep it in color. And then I was like, in fact, I'm gonna keep it at 100 colors, because that just brings in all kinds of detail. And then I was like, it still, you know, looks kind of weird with like this smudgy little bits on his cheek. Instead, it looks a little blurry. I don't like it. So then I came to my paths, which were at 50, and I brought them to 100 to bring back some more detail. That ended up looking pretty good. Still a little weird. So then I was like, I don't know, I'm gonna play around with this corners. And it was at 50 and I brought it to 0. I mean, at first I brought it to 100, then I brought it to 0. And I found that, and that's what sometimes you gotta do. If you have the PC power to do it, just like go to extremes with these sliders so that you can see exactly what they're doing. Because when you go to the extreme, you'll see like the fullest extent of the effect, which will give you an idea of, all right, that's what it's doing. So this is what I did. Now the game changer here, for whatever reason, was when I brought the noise to 1. But what? That's crazy, man. It looks exactly like the original, right? What? So anyway, look at all that detail. And that is a vector. Insane. So yeah, that's how you do it, you know? That's how you do it for a watercolor, for a basic logo, and for a highly detailed line drawing. And really quick, I just want to give a shout out to Hemlock Customs. This guy, his name's Jesse. He is amazing. He does all kind of custom leather work and woodwork. And he does like these custom Nintendo Switch holders with like the Zelda logo on it. He does custom gun holsters, wallets. I mean, you name it, this guy does it. So if you're into that kind of stuff, go check him out. And thanks for watching. I hope this helped you. And I hope that you now feel confident in turning your raster file into a vector. All right, until next time.